Hello everyone and welcome to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today's video is going to be focusing all on Grammarly. Grammarly is a spell checking application that you can install on pretty much all of your devices, allowing you to get real-time spell checking as well as punctuation and sentence structure support. So instead of making like loads of blunders on emails and even on social messages, you can actually avoid that sort of mistake. Now, today I'm actually gonna be passing over to Jamie over at Teachers Tech. He runs a awesome YouTube channel that is dedicated to talking about software that will be useful for teachers as well as individuals and professionals for getting things done. So hopefully you'll find as much value as you do in this channel over on Jamie's. So feel free to jump over to his. So without further ado, I'll pass over to Jamie for this one. Thanks for coming on, Jamie. I really appreciate it. And guys, I hope you learn everything you need to know about Grammarly. Cheers.
Thank you, Francesco, for having me on your channel. It's a pleasure to be working with you on a little collaboration here today. I've been following your channel for quite some time here, and I've always enjoyed your productivity reviews. I go there quite a bit to learn about the most current apps that are out there that can help me organize my YouTube channel too. So let's get started on what I'm going to be talking about tonight here on your channel here, and it's going to be Grammarly. And if you haven't used Grammarly yet, I use it all the time. I don't consider myself a great writer, so this is something I need to have to make sure everything works efficiently and fast. I can, whether it be at work or maybe just writing a blog or even on my YouTube channel in the description, I want to go through and show you all the different places you can use Grammarly. I'm going to be logging into my account, which is a paid for account, but I'll point out the differences with the free to paid one too. So let's get started here on this review of Grammarly tonight. So I'm just going to go ahead and get logged into my Grammarly. And remember what I said, I do have a paid for version that I'll be showing and has all the options on it. So I'm going to go ahead, get logged in the top right hand corner, just log in with my account here. And once I'm logged in, you can kind of see it maybe like compared to like Google Drive, how I have all these different documents here that I can open up that stores inside Grammarly. Now this right here, I want to point out what it says, add the Grammarly extension to Chrome. And this is something I uninstalled it just to show you how to install it. So just go ahead and click it and add the extension, and you're going to have it added to your extensions in Chrome up at the top right hand corner. It will just pop open a window to kind of show you what are the different things that it can do. So going back to that now, you can see I have it installed, and that's really handy. And I'm going to show you a little bit later how it will work in your Gmail or maybe Facebook or Twitter to make sure anything you write there is going to be correct. So if I go over to my apps here on the left hand side and just click on apps, you can see now Grammarly for Chrome is active. If you're interested, you can install this for Microsoft Office or Grammarly's for Windows. So just to point out, I'm not going to be showing you in this little overview of it today, but just to show you, it is there. So I'm just going to go to my Grammarly here and just open up one of the documents that I have, and I'll just open up this 3D printing one. I know there's going to be mistakes in this, so it's just something quickly I wrote up here. So I can see it's checking it right up in the top right hand corner, and it says correct with assistant, gives me 4 criticals and 2 advanced. So I can click one, I can look at it from here. You can see when I hover over it, it will ask, what do I want? Do I want to dismiss it? Do I want to see more? And it opens up the assistant over here. So I like how I can actually learn from Grammarly. So you can be reading the suggestions to it. You can show more, where they're just going to give you a little bit of information that you can go through. So I don't necessarily do that. I just take the corrections and kind of read through it again. But it is, if you are interested in learning from the information they give you, you can do that. So when you want to switch it, I can click up here and it makes the change, do you want to, and moves to the next one. So that was just the way I phrased it. There's nothing wrong with the spelling. But on the second one here, there is something wrong with the spelling. You can see I've spelled downloading wrong, and I can go ahead and just click it on here. So really, now this is conciseness. Maybe there's the saying, well, I've used this too many times, and it says, it appears that that really may be unnecessary in this one. So if I kind of take it for what they say, and then if that's the case, I can click on it and make it disappear. So again, this didn't fit here. They're saying I need an S on this. I can go through. And on this one, they say maybe I should put a but in front of it and get rid of the extra the. So you can see kind of how you can go through very, very, very quickly if you're writing something up and make all those corrections. And it's more than just checking your spelling. It's connecting it to correct grammar on it too. And I like how it kind of teaches you as it goes along. I could take this now, I could copy paste, I could grab this all, right click and copy this and put this into the description on my YouTube channel. If you want to get a little deeper into your writing, take a look at the insights on the side over here. So if I click on it, you can see I get the document insights, but I also can get vocabulary and readability scores too. We can set goals in here, so this will make suggestions and customize towards your writing if you go through and answer these. We also have plagiarism and human proofreader, but remember, I'm on a premium account right now and all these options aren't available in the free one. So if I go through, and this is where I like the extension, I'm over here in Twitter and I have the extension installed and it picks up the errors right through here. This is all through Grammarly, so I could go through and click on it and make the correction just by selecting what I want. But I can also open it up here and it's going to open it in a Grammarly window, and then I can make the changes and go through and just click on all these like this and then go back to Twitter and it will make the adjustments in here. You can see if I go over to Facebook, it shows up in Facebook also, and even in Gmail, if I wanna make that quick change, and you can see now it's gonna come up as corrected here, and you're just gonna get the green G here. So those are the kind of the key features where I use it most with Grammarly and the extension. Here's a little side-by-side comparison from the free to the premium. I used free for a long time before I got the premium. I just got the premium on a really good price discount, so I went and got it there. You can see that the free will take care of your grammar and spelling, but if you're digging deeper and you wanted to look at more things, like some of the options I showed you, then take a look at the premium and see if the price is something that that will match up to your needs on it. So I hope you like this walkthrough of Grammarly and gave you an insights whether or not this is something you would use. Thank you to Francesco for having me on his channel. Hopefully we can collaborate again on a different one. I know he has just put a video on my channel about Google, about the new Google task. So go over there and take a look. I do weekly tech tips on my channel too. So if you're interested, just take a look. I believe Francesco will probably put in the link down below. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.